A lot of people separate their lives into work life and private life. My philosophy is that you should consider them as a whole. After all, you only got one brain, and it won't separate them.
Klaus Müller is today's high priest of life and time management. He preaches a philosophy and teaches practical techniques on how to manage your life and time to get the best from yourself and from other people. In 1976, he founded Time Manager International, just outside Copenhagen in Denmark. In just over a decade, his ideas have spread throughout the world to more than 30 countries, from Japan to Iceland, and from Canada to New Zealand. Nearly a million people now use his philosophy to help manage their lives. His ideas have made him a multimillionaire and one of the biggest names in management training. Müller's clients range from the Danish royal family to British Airways and Scandinavian Airlines, and from IBM to Audi VW. Like these managers, they're all devotees of his rather unorthodox approach.
When you are together with other people, it is very important that you pay a lot of attention to your own behavior the first 4 minutes, because this behavior will decide your relationship with other people. And it may decide the way you cope with other people and the way you enjoy life together. Kjell, do you live together with a partner?
Yes, I have a partner.
It is very important when you come home from this course to come home as James Bond. You have to make what we call the James Bond approach. Have you ever seen a James Bond movie, Kjell?
Yes, I have.
Does he make complaints when he comes home from work?
No.
He has worn a rubber suit the whole day, and he has been working underneath the water, fighting against Russian spies, and he has been shot in his back, or in his bum, by a shark filled with nuclear weapons. Does he make complaints? Does he come home and say... No. He's taking off his rubber suit, and what has he got inside? Right, a white dinner jacket. And he says... Good evening. My name is Bond. James Bond. This is the way you have to approach your partner. You have to approach the house each evening by saying, good evening. My name is Thompson. Kjell Thompson. Many people are in situations at home or at work where they find it very difficult to motivate themselves. They don't achieve as much as they want to, and then end up blaming everybody except themselves. It's your approach to life that will decide the quality of your life. You can take what I call the single bagger or the double bagger approach. The single bagger thinks it's a lousy job, and the single bagger works very, very slowly and couldn't really care about the sequence of which he or she is putting the goods into the bags. The single bagger works very, very slowly. And when the cashier says, hurry up, a lot of people are waiting, the single bagger will say, come on, I only got two hands. The double bagger takes two bags, therefore the name. And the double bagger is working quite fast, and the double bagger can afford a smile. And the double bagger will go out to the parking area and assist the client, open the booth, and say, hope to see you again. We are always confronted with crossroads. You can either choose the single bagger or the double bagger road. Every time you choose the double bagger road, you'll get more out of your life. Psychologists refer to these two different attitudes to life as winners and losers. Winner behavior will produce positive results, and loser behavior will produce negative results or zero results. Two people are talking with each other, one very experienced person and another person not so experienced. If the experienced person is a winner, he or she would tend to say, "You never get too old to learn new tricks." The loser would tend to say, "Do you know how many years of experience I have in this business?" "No." "I have 25 years experience." "Is this person right?" "No, this person only has 1 year of experience, but it is 25 years old." Enjoy this moment, and this is what life is all about, enjoying moments and concentrating on the present. Do not spoil the present by feeling guilty about the past and fearing the future. Try to be in control of the future, especially the next 24 hours. Scientists have shown that one of the main causes for stress is that you're not in control of the next day. To achieve results and work well, you have to be in control. And to be in control, you need an overview of what you do. A lot of people are afraid of losing creativity if they plan too much. And this is maybe why a lot of creative people are not very organized. But they are not creative because of this mess, rather in spite of it. If you don't have a system and you are not organized, your entire life will be in chaos. Many of us can't see the wood for the trees. What we need is a structure for everything we do. Nature manages to be both organized and creative. Imagine that the trunk represents your goals in life: to be healthy, to enjoy your job. The branches are your key areas, what you have to focus on to reach those goals. A fitness plan to be healthy, perhaps. The twigs are your major tasks, what you actually have to work on to achieve your life goals. And the pine needles represent all the minor tasks you have to do from day to day. To be in control, you need to build a bridge between what you want to do and when you want to do it.
Klaus Müller has developed a system to help you achieve this. It provides a way to link what you want to do and how and when you're going to do it. The what and how needs to be broken down into four levels, starting with your overall goals. Your goals could concern your health, your job, and your relationships. Next, your key areas, what you actually have to focus on to achieve those goals. Take your job. Say you're a manager. Your key areas might include staff, finance, work, contacts, and home. For each key area, list all the major tasks, what you actually have to do to get results in each key area. When you've listed all the major tasks for all your key areas, you have an overview, an overall plan of everything you need to do in your life. By spending time on these, you'll start to get the results you want, and you'll be in control. Major tasks for work projects might be install a computer, organize a company anniversary, a trade fair. It helps to decide deadlines for these. The final level is made up of the minor tasks, the detailed plans. For a trade fair, you might book the stand, select products, and train sales staff. The next step is to build a bridge between these four levels. What you want to achieve and how, and when you're going to achieve it. Your diary. The diary should consist of your yearly plan, your monthly plan, your weekly plan, and, the most important, your daily plan. It gives you control over the next 24 hours. First, fill in fixed appointments from your weekly or monthly plan. Allow some time for unexpected events. Then fill in the available time with any major or minor tasks that you can tackle that day. Klaus Müller claims that by planning your time every day, you'll keep a regular check on how you're spending it, making sure your time is put to the best use to achieve your long-term goals. It's not only individuals who can benefit from using Klaus Müller's ideas. Departments and whole companies use his system to coordinate their goals and key areas. Klaus Müller believes this helps employees to work towards the same objectives. And it's not only the private sector that can benefit. Even government bureaucracies have adopted Müller's ideas, including the Danish Prime Minister's office. Last year, Müller signed a contract with the entire EEC. 15,000 employees will be trained in his techniques. And in an historic agreement, the Soviet Union has started to use the Müller philosophy. It's the first time the Soviets have used a management consultant from the West and paid for business advice in hard currency. Boris Pastukov is the Soviet ambassador to Denmark. What does he think of the deal?
Я верю, что у сотрудничества между Time Manager и советскими организациями большое будущее. А если добавить к этому, что методика Time Manager предполагает сочетание интересов личности работающего и интересов коллектива, предприятия, фирмы, отрасли, то это нам также чрезвычайно важно, ибо мы придаем человеческому фактору сейчас особое значение.
In order to create a good culture in a company or in an organization, it's very important to focus more on the human factor. For quite a few years, I have been working as a management consultant, and I don't think I have ever faced marketing problems or technical problems or financial problems that we were not able to solve. But I must admit that I have faced a lot of people problems. I think the reason is that we here in the Western world are brought up to manage facts, which means all the things in the so-called bottom line world. We are not brought up to manage feelings, the things in the beyond bottom line world. Liz is coming to me. Let us assume I'm a bottom line person. And she says to me, Klaus, I have to rush to hospital because one of my kids have been brought to hospital. Then the bottom line person would say, well, okay, one has to go to hospital because one's kids are ill, but please remember it's only 11 o'clock, so if it's not serious, I expect you to be back here within a few hours, okay? This bottom line person knows nothing about how to inspire people. I'm not sure that this bottom line person will be able to motivate as much as a mouse in a cheese factory. The beyond bottom line person would say this. Is it Tom or is it Mary? And she may say, it's Mary. And I say, okay, go there immediately. Take a taxi on the company. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure it's not serious, but give me a ring when you know what it is. I would like to know it. Okay. Hi. You may be thinking, my God, in that case, the beyond bottom line person has to know the names of the children of the staff. Do you think that is necessary if you want to inspire people?
Yes.
It is, I can tell you. What you get out of your moments and your entire life will be determined very much on your own attitude to life and your entire behavior. And your behavior, whether it's a single-bagger behavior or a double-bagger behavior, whether it's loser behavior or a winner behavior, will be determined first and foremost by your thoughts and feelings about yourself. Your behavior will be determined by your self-esteem, and your self-esteem will be determined by the recognition that you get. And in order to inspire yourself, you need recognition. In order to inspire other people, you have to give them recognition. Not superficial recognition, not superficial strokes, not by saying, that is great, that is super, that is fantastic, what a nice shirt you have on, Lars, I like your tie, or by giving all your staff a Christmas turkey. That is not enough. You have to mean it. The best stroke you can receive and the best stroke you can give to other people is attention. Paul, you are my father, and I'm your son, 6 years old. You are sitting there drinking some coffee and reading the newspaper. And I'm coming to you and I say, Daddy, please come to my room. There's something I want to show you. And Daddy says, no, Daddy's reading the newspaper. If I go away from that, you know, it's one of these kinds of newspapers where the ink will go if you disappear from that. The son makes another attempt and he tries again. Daddy, come to my room. There's something I want to show you. And Daddy says, no, I have to finish my coffee. Otherwise, it gets cold. And then I say, Daddy, come to my room. No, Daddy says, you can tell me what it is. This is not attention. But this is attention. As soon as the sun comes, you move your bum off the chair and you go to the son's room now. And when you get there, and you ask your son, what was it you wanted to tell Daddy or show to Daddy? Then the son may say, this one, for instance. What is it that your child tries to communicate to you? I need attention. I need you for myself 100% without competition from anybody else. This is attention. When you pay attention to your staff, it is very important that you do it in a genuine way. Now I'm the managing director and Ole, you are the computer manager, okay? And I come into your office and I say, good morning, Ole. Mm-hmm. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Good. And are you busy?
Oh, yes, very much so.
Yeah. I think it's better to be busy than not to be busy, right?
Yes.
A lot of people are making complaints for not being busy, so... And so on and so forth. This is not the way to pay attention. No. If you don't know anything about what Ole is doing, you don't have to demonstrate it. He already knows. Right? This is the way you should do it. Go into Ole's office and say to him, hi, Ole. Good morning.
Hi.
I just went to the sales department and I learned that they have received a new sales statistics. There are no mistakes in it whatsoever. And they are very happy because it gives them a much better overview than the previous one. And I know who did it. Thank you very much, Ole. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Done a good job. I appreciate it. This is the way you pay attention. But you have to mean it and only say it if you mean it. But if people just could go so far as saying what they mean, expressing the good feelings that they have about other people, then we would have achieved quite a lot. Welcome to the Royal Theatre of Copenhagen. Tonight, I am the guest conductor and I am in control. It would be tempting to compare manager with a conductor directing all the musicians to play harmoniously and get the best results out of each musician. Marketing, sales, distribution, production. However, surveys show that the comparison between the manager and the conductor does not reflect real life. Sometimes it would make more sense to compare the manager with a puppet being pulled and being tugged from all directions by a lot of disorganized people. Many people make decisions on the use of their time based on what comes up today. Telephone calls, drop-in visitors, letters, and a lot of unexpected events. By using methods and practical ways, you can be in control and you can be the conductor of your own life.
Of which is discussed now on to In Business Matters.